Amen. We're glad to be able to be here. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let me give these announcements before we get started. Wednesday night, service and youth group starts at 6 o'clock. Encourage you to come be part of that. Our Sunday school at 10 o'clock is some good teaching. I encourage you to come and be part of that. And our regular 11 o'clock service, of course, encourage others to come. There's some, still some lift here in the vestibule, I think, maybe a little bit. And we got next Sunday, Phil Sunday dinner this month, in honor of our sister, Pam Parker, going to Texas. And so everyone start preparing to fry some chicken. I said that pretty regular, Brother Dave. So we're hopeful to have some, but we're going to be having time together, just to spend a little time with our sister. So come on and let's be part of that. And if you'd like to write Sister Ann a note, a card, to encourage her, there's going to be a basket already in the vestibule there that you put there, something, give her something to read, son, all along the way. How much we love her. We hopefully, by the grace of God, we'll keep praying for her, or at least she'll keep praying for us. Amen. Thank you. Praise God. We want to take our prayer request of the Lord in prayer. That we will start in the choir. Praying for Wendy's Aunt Pat and for Jack, because I know that's pretty tough in your life. So, Lord, the mother said she had some surgery this week.
Yes,
okay. Prayer request. Prayer request.
God is good.
Amen. Praise God.
Being in the cross and our family, especially healing without healing.
Yes. Gene said healing's going to be having another. The other side, hip replacement done Monday, tomorrow. So we need to be praying for him. You know, we're holding up for the Lord. Another prayer request?
Has the month spoken?
Spoken?
I have spoken.
Spoken.
Thank you. Enjoyed hearing Brother Billy this week. Really good. Good to see you.
Yes, I did. It was good, Brother Roger. Talking about we were blessed. I tell you what, the men just got away to share the word of God. It's a blessing. I'll tell you what. We have some good fellowship. Other prayer requests? Bruce?
I have some much spoken.
Much spoken too. All right. Anyone else back here? This side? Prayer request?
It's in here, whoever else.
Amen, Jerry. Other prayer request?
Just pray for the baby and Jesus and thank you for praying
about the baby. But for those of you that wasn't here with us in the out here in front of Sunday school, Wanda said that Rachel's great-granddaughter is a spina bifida, born with that and having a please remember to pray for him. Had the surgery now, you said?
I did surgery last night.
Remember that. Other prayer request?
Our neighbor, he lives, his wife, he's in so much trouble. And I'm sure you're in that way. But this lady here, I have to take the cast off. So much is going on. I think that they're trying to break the problem. So that should release the pressure.
When are they going to take this?
They're going back to the doctor sometime this week. They're having a couple of infections, so that's, they're waiting on that too. It's like every couple of weeks they have to get.
It's a long-term situation. Eddie Glass.
He had, you know, their son, he has a home on this, and it's hard on him. The chef's having a good time. So he kind of gets some.
He has a lot of pressure on her. We'll do that. Or keep praying for Eddie Glass. Yes, thank you. Other prayer request? Praying for one another. We got a, I know Bob had told us in Sunday school, this is a good report. Even though I know Terry's still having to go through things, but Terry Yates, they did the surgery on him in Tallahassee. Apparently successful. And now he'll be over 3 or 4 more weeks for physical therapy. And Bob says, hopefully he's going to come back and turn his saw on. We're going to hope he can do that here. But we're just thankful that he's been through a lot, I'll tell you. And to hear that, because they didn't expect, I don't think, in one go around, Bill. He just done it, did it, Bob, and played Sam. But they, it's a blessing, so let's continue, keep praying for them. Ms. Beulah asked, we pray for the Billy Bird family, remember them. I know Roger mentioned this. If y'all will, keep praying for Deborah, her family, losing her son Derek. I know it's, keep praying for her. Of course, these other two families, the Turner family and the Mock family, and some losses. And also, Tony and Carol, I believe, are on the road traveling. Right, Arkansas. Yeah. Ain't no flying? They're flying. All right. Remember them? Hopefully get on back home then. James DePass Smith. I've asked prayer for him. I sent word out. I mean, Pam had. They have told him he's got some type of bone cancer. And I know that somebody's told me about here that Billy said that he's seen where they went to Atlanta. He's up there to see the doctor. But I don't know. I hadn't seen anything yet to tell me what the situation is. He wanted to find out what they could do. But so remember him and Pat, be praying for them. But just hold them up. I mean, they're listening. Also, if you will, I got a call last night from Nicky Goodman. Leonard's at the place. He passed away. He's very near death. He's in tough shape. Said he just, here in the last week or so, he really took a turn. He's not doing it at all. They got him on the ventilator and all, so she's just trying to get everything squared away and right. She needs prayer, really pray for Vicky. I mean, for Leonard, I know he needs prayer, but hold Vicky up. She's trying to hold this thing up and do. She told me it's been 48 years with her, God bless her heart. So remember them, a young man that Pam's been, some of her family knows real well up in Tennessee. A young man, what, he about 17 or so? Senior in high school. Anyway, he had a tree basically that fell over and hit him. And he'd been in tough shape. Grayson Pope. But his grandmother sent an update talking about it, how they're looking to the Lord. So please pray for him, Grayson Pope. He needs a continued continued heating, there's been some progress, but he's here in tough shape. Also, if y'all remember Shane and Denise, they're over at Baldwin, they're here to order God, so remember them, pray for them today. And Brother Gerald, Brother Gerald, for the roof last night, he's in touch with the Lord, so please remember him and pray for him. God strengthen Brother Gerald. Also, let's keep praying for one another at Oak Grove. We got a number of people in different situations, but we need prayer. Keep praying for one another. Remember the church as a whole, around the world, keep praying for fellow believers. The Lighthouse Ministry, we mentioned earlier to you about Brother Billy and Sister Betty, keep praying for them. They really need a touch from the Lord and healing. That ministry they've got there, the Highway Shepherd Ministry that Brother Biddy was telling some about this week again, that he made mention of, I don't know how many years it's been now, but they've been helping support that ministry. He told, they give it out now, it's somewhere between 70,000 and 90,000 CDs a year, so they've had a lot of good reports back. It's been good that God's saving folks. Remember our missionaries in the field, the hospitals and the nursing homes, remember Miss Shirley, Miss Annette there at the nursing home. Remember our nation, we pray for the healing of our nation. Remember our first responders, our jails and our prisons, our military and their family, our elected officials. To pray is 1 Timothy 2 and 2 commands us for all that are in authority. Yes, sir. God's called us to do that. Remember our youth here and our teachers and keep praying for them. They really blessed me Wednesday night. They came show down there at the meeting, and I tell you, I had several of them down there, how blessed they were, Brother Biddy, and talked about how they felt God in the presence, and how they disturbed the amen sound, though Brother Biddy was a blessing, and God used it. And I'm thankful for our youth that they got to be there, be a part of that. So we thank the Lord for that. So remember their teachers also here, keep holding them up before the Lord. For Israel and for the folks in Afghanistan and Ukraine. Let's keep remembering these. A lot of heartaches in this world, I tell you. Anyone else that I need?
Well,
Michael Hightower and his family. He's in pretty tough shape with BQAB having this infection. We did say 20-something surgeons the last couple of years probably, so please pray for him. Remember, on the floor, kind of children there too. Anyone else? Lucius?
Remember Lee and Alvin Redmond. They in a hard spot. I understand they want to take one of Lee's kidneys. I'm not sure. I mean, Alvin. I'm quite a herd now.
Just keep praying for Lee and Alvin. Let's hold them up for the Lord. They are in the Brother David, I want to ask you, Brazil, if you will, lead us. And let's pray together, let's ask God to help us this morning.
Come before you again this morning. Thank you for the time of prayer.
Hallelujah.
Think about how great a God you are. Said, if it had not been for the Lord that was on our side, Father, we know that your hand is not short. Heavy today. bless you for the good word we've heard this week. Your servant has come to share it, and glorify the Lord, and probably bless you for your presence of the covenant of service even this morning. Thank for the word that's been given to the Sunday school hour, the message. We bless you for these requests today, God. We're lifting them up before you. For these many families, many dear people, church families, dire straits, the needs of a special touch upon their bodies and lives today. You can give. These are not with us this morning, but your own, these others, Father, we want to thank you for the privilege of prayer. Prayer moves the hands of people.
Hallelujah.
To move the world. We pray this morning to have you with the hearts of these today. Then you lost among us, we pray, for the Spirit of God to rule and to draw. To move upon the hearts today, that each one sees the need of the great Savior, the great love of the Lord had for us, and laying down his life at Calvary. Thank God this morning we have a resurrected Savior.
Yes, praise
God. Bless you for the preciousness that you are to us today. In Jesus' name we pray.
Let's stand on 281 and pray with us.
Thank you.
song. And I want you to see, excuse me, that the, this whole song, we sing the chorus a lot, and it's a blessing to me. But it says, the chimes of time ring out for you, another day is through. Someone slipped and failed, that someone you. You may have longed for added strength, your courage to renew. Do not be disheartened, I have news for you. And of course, here, it's no secret what God can do. He said then in the second stanza, he said, there is no night for you in this life, you'll never walk alone. You'll always feel at home wherever you may roam. There is no power can conquer you. But God is on your side. Take him at his promise. Don't run away and hide. It is no secret what God can do. What he's done for others, he'll do for you. With arms wide open, he'll pardon you. It is no secret what God can do. And it's surely not. I was thinking about this song in my mind that here in the, I want to begin to read in the book of Matthew chapter 19. And beginning in verse 23. And I want to share a little something. It's no secret what God can do. And it's surely not. Says, then Jesus said unto his disciples. Now, he had just had an interaction with a young man that was very rich. He said, verily I say unto you, that a rich man shall hardly enter into the kingdom of heaven. Well, that was a tremendous statement for Jesus to make to his disciples when he came to save sinners. He came into the world. As he said to Pilate, to this end came I into the world to die for sinners. And again I say unto you, it is easier for a camel to go through the eye of a needle than for a rich man to enter into the kingdom of heaven. Now his disciples, when they heard this, they had a question. Who then can be saved? They were amazed that Jesus said this, that he made this statement. But to me, what he says next is what I want to talk about when we talk about it. It's no secret what God can do. Now I know that around this world, in a lot of places, they don't want somebody speaking the name of Jesus. I know in some countries they'll put people in prison to death for saying the very name of Jesus. But I want you to know that what Jesus said here in verse 26 then, he said, Jesus beheld them and said unto them, with men this is impossible. You see, salvation is not of man's making. Man don't have that power. I said here the other day when we were talking about in the on one of the Sundays that God gives us a call. We're to see that the fields are white and harvest. We're to go forth and to carry the seed of the Word of God, our testimony. We're to water that Word that maybe been given out to somebody along the way. But it's God that has to give the increase. God does the saving. That's why he gets the glory. Hallelujah. Man is not to. He said, with men it's impossible, with God all things are possible. You see, it's no secret. God can do what's impossible. He can do what man cannot do. He can save sinners. Hallelujah. He can do things in our lives and for us that we would never even imagine. So he tells us this over in Hebrews 7 and 25. Wherefore, in view of this, what Jesus has been saying here, he is able also to save them to the uttermost that come unto God by him, seeing he ever liveth to make intercession for them. And so, he came into the world, and as he said, what's impossible with men is possible with God. So Jesus, who is able, is from the world. I'm sorry, y'all. Go ahead. He said, he is able to save to the uttermost. In other words, Jesus is able, that word uttermost, to save completely. He does that work. There is no Jesus plus. It's Jesus, hallelujah. He saves lost men, women, boys, and girls. He's able to save to the uttermost all that have come unto God by Him. And why can He make this promise? He ever lives. Hallelujah. I know that though He died on the cross at Calvary, He overcame death, rose from the dead. He's now at the right hand of the Father. Stephen gave testimony to that as he was being stoned to death there. Hallelujah. As he looked up and he said, "Behold, I see the Son of God standing on the right hand of the Father." Hallelujah. Knowing that He is there interceding on our behalf. And the thing is that I want us to get a hold of as believers, praise God. It's no secret what God can do. I can say to you here today, if you're here and you don't know Jesus Christ as Savior, no matter we may say, because I said and I was going to figure it out all before God saved me, I was going to read the Bible, figure the Bible out, see what was really going on, until God got me to that place, hallelujah, that He took me hearing the Word of God, but yet faith in my heart, and hallelujah, one morning, riding the Word, glory to God, He made it real to me, hallelujah, as I read the account of the thief on the cross, that glory to God, all I had to do was ask Him, call on His name, get saved. And so, it's not a secret, but somehow or another, you see, there's the enemy in this world that seeks to blind the mind of those that hear the gospel. But Jesus told them here. I mean, His own disciples were amazed when He said what He did about salvation. In essence, saying there's just only one way, hallelujah, for man to be saved, and that's through the work of the Lord Jesus Christ. That we come, hallelujah, to Him. And so what we want to be sure that we make clear as believers, that we make clear to this world, that we tell those, because I know everybody, we hear different things, you know, whether it's the children or, you know, you're sure that you're telling them the right thing. What we need to do is tell others what Jesus has done for us. And trust God to do the saving. It's no secret, hallelujah, God does the saving. Now the second thing that I tell you is that He makes intercession for them, but over Luke chapter 19, verse 10, He tells us the Son of Man has come to seek and to save that which was lost. Now the thing that I thought about when we sang the song, and it was coming to my mind the other day, and even as Brother Billy was sharing the Word of God some this week and talking about, you know, the salvation of God. And hallelujah, how that it's not a secret of what God can do. I know that men have their minds blinded. I recognize and realize that in the world that we live in, we see things happen that we don't understand, that we struggle with sometimes. I've heard it said a lot of times, well, how can God allow this or this to happen? And I understand those are the kind of things that as finite human beings we struggle about. But the key to this is that God has announced and made this, hallelujah, known to the world that Jesus came to seek and to save that which was lost. He said it this way in Matthew chapter 28. He says to you and I as believers. Now they had come, and as the Bible said, Jesus came unto his own received not, speaking of the Jewish world. Jesus came, they didn't receive the message that He had, praise God. They rejected Him, and so much so that they committed Him to death, the death of the cross. But see, Jesus had come to this end, that He might die for sinners. And so He tells you and I as believers, as Jesus came and He told them, He said, this is Jesus speaking. He said, go ye therefore and teach all nations. This is not a secret organization. This is not some kind of particular thing that has got all these different rituals and things that they do that are secret and only can be known, you know, if we reveal them to somebody. No, sir, Jesus Christ has been revealed to the world. And so He says to you and I as believers, Go ye therefore and teach all nations. You know, that ought to solve everything. I've wondered a lot of times how anybody ever wondered, praise God, is the gospel for all? Yes, hallelujah, red, yellow, black, and white, it's for all. The word of God. He said, go and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. He tells us, praise God, to go forth into this world. And then in verse 20, he says, in completing that, teaching them to observe all things whatsoever I commanded you. Lo, I'm with you always, even unto the end of the world. Amen. So you see, when we sing that little song, that little chorus, it is no secret what God can do. The gospel's not hid in that respect. It's hid sometimes because men have been deceived, and I hate to say this, but I'm afraid a lot of times religion in the world has hid Jesus Christ from the world. It shouldn't be that way. You see, he is the reason that we have religion, hallelujah, that we practice what we do, that glory to God, we come and we gather up with God's children, that we announce to the world that, listen, Jesus, hallelujah, is our Savior. Because it's no secret what God can do. I mean, hallelujah, I think about it, and I look back a little bit and I thought about, you think about a man like John Newton that wrote the song Amazing Grace. Now, he was a slave trader at one time. Now, he had done through different things, and he wound up, the way he wound up being on a slave ship, prepared from what I read, is that he was on the naval ship, Great Britain. He got in trouble. They traded him off to the slave ship. He found out it was a profitable business. He got into it. But he talked about that, and he became one of the forces there that worked with Wilberforce in England to do away with slavery. The thing about it is, God saved him, and he wrote a song that God saved the rich like me. The glory to God, he recognized it's no secret what God can do. He saves. Paul called himself chief of sinners, but yet God saved him. You see, God goes, hallelujah, to wherever man needs him. It's no secret God saves sinners. It's no secret, hallelujah. I don't know why it is that sometimes we behave as if it is. We become afraid to speak about what Jesus has done for us. We find ourselves being very timid in situations and places. You know, where really, the truth of the matter is, this Bible is no secret. It's in the world, praise God. And I'll tell you what, no matter how many different men, how many different nations literally have tried to do away with the Word of God, they've not ever been able to. God preserves it. It's no secret what God can do. It's here. He gives us, and so we need to be as Jesus told him. He said, look, even though he had been rejected of his own, and he had went to Calvary and died for the sins of man, he tells his disciples to go out into the world telling others about him. Because it's not a secret, hallelujah, what God can do. He saves sinners. He goes, hallelujah. He tells us this in Isaiah chapter 52 and verse 10. He says, the Lord hath made bare his holy arm. And Isaiah, boy, spoke a lot about the salvation of God. He has made bare his holy arm. In other words, he has shown forth his power in the eyes of all the nations of the world. And all the ends of the earth shall see the salvation of our God. It should be that, glory to God, we recognize when we look about and we see the testimonies of what God does. He saves sinners. Hallelujah. He delivers. He rescues. You know, I tell you, it's no wonder that the psalmist wrote Psalm 23. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall fear no evil. I thought about it, and I looked back in my life when God began to deal with me. And I'm sure if I went back in my life as a young fella because of the Word of God that I heard. And then as time went on and I was in the condition that I'd come to be in as a sinner, not because I hadn't heard anything about Jesus, I'd heard. I knew, hallelujah, And what happened is then I began to find out, boy, I went off in the military. You know the story. I lost my son, Corey. He passed away, and I was in a hard place. And God sent me, hallelujah, to a place. And then I remember Mom and Daddy calling up there and talking to us and telling me, not a river got saved. I said, it wasn't no secret that, boy, God, hallelujah. And all night he talked about how many years he went and he tried to listen to see. But God saved me. And it made an impression on me because I'm going to tell you something. I know you for a long time, for quite a few years through there, before I ever went off. But I thought about how it was that God's Word, he put me, I'm telling you, let me tell you, back in those days and up around Fort Bragg and Spring Lake and Fayetteville, it was some rough places. But God set me and Pam right beside a brother and sister in the Lord that loved me. And I'll tell you, they kept praying for this old boy. She'd remind me, if Pam come home for a week or two, she'd be there making sure I remembered who I was. She prayed for me. He prayed for me. And as I've said many times, she was one of the first people I called when God saved me and let her know. But I think about, he has buried his holy arm in the eyes of all nations. All the ends of earth shall see the salvation of our God. He makes it known. We can know. God touched me in those situations. And as I heard about, you know, the different ones that I've seen here, I think back and through the years, the different ones that God saved, and so many through here. I thought about it. I wrote down some names, different ones, but I thought about it. Remember the old fella, was his name Lindy, that used to come here and play that piano? I mean, I want to tell you, folks, he was from a rough side of town, but God saved him. Hallelujah. He could play a piano like it was nothing. So, but God saved him. I've seen God save him. I think back for me anyway in my life, and I think about, I know good well for Brother Roger and them, and me, some of the old Brother Richard, God saved him. Boy, I tell you, he never got tired of telling folks. It wasn't no secret, hallelujah, that God had saved him. He wanted you to know about it. I think about old Sister May Boardman, Steve English's sister, that came. I still remember when Brother Jesse Norris was here preaching, and she'd come, and God saved her, and my daddy told me later, he said, you know, he said, from that morning when God saved her, she said, when I seen her that night, I said, she just looked different. God's salvation. You see, it's not no secret what God can do. He saves, hallelujah. And like John Newton, people that we know, hallelujah, in this life, in this world, we could go on and on with the different ones. But he has made it known. We have seen the salvation of our God. Psalms 19, 1 through 4 tells us this about salvation of God. He said, the heavens declare the glory of God. The firmament, all that we see here, the environment that we're in, they show the handiwork of God. Day unto day literally speaks. Night unto night showeth knowledge. There is no speech nor language where the voice is not heard. Their line has gone out through all the earth, their words to the end of the world. In them hath he set a tabernacle for the sun. God speaks. It's no secret what God can do. His creation speaks of it. Tells us that he is. You know, that's why when he wrote in Hebrews chapter 6, that God is, and he's a rewarder of those that diligently seek him. The very creation itself tells us that God is. He says this to us in the book of Acts chapter 2, verses 38 and 39. He said, Peter said unto them, repent. Now he's speaking to all these folks here, these thousands that have gathered up, hallelujah, after they've been filled with the Holy Spirit of God. He said, repent, be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ, for the remission or forgiveness of sins, and you shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. He said, for the promise is unto you, and to your children, and to all that are far off, even as many as the Lord our God shall call. He's faithful. God didn't hide this. He and stick it in a corner. It's been proclaimed, hallelujah, that God is. He's let us know that this promise of salvation has gone into all the world. And so, you know, at times if we get in this circumstance of trying to say, well, this one can, this one can't, this one... Now, I'm going to tell you something. As Jesus said to those disciples that day, what's impossible with men is possible with God. God, hallelujah, does the same. Now, He gives you and I plenty to do. He told us, go out and tell folks, tell the world, it's not a secret what God can do. Hallelujah, He saves sinners. Glory to God, He's going to one day, praise God, make this whole place new again. He tells us this in Romans chapter 10, verse 17 and 18. Faith will come by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. But I say, now he's quoting here from the Old Testament. He says, have they not heard? Yes, verily. Their sound went into all the earth. Now remember, faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. And their words have been heard up to the ends of the world. This was never meant to be a secret. I'm going to tell you something. As awful as it seems, Jesus was beaten and crucified before the world. But it was never meant to be done in some corner and hid away. Jesus came and gave himself. What's the Bible say? For God so loved the world. It's no secret. Hallelujah. We need to tell folks what Jesus has done for us. Glory to God that he's given us, hallelujah, salvation. The sound has went into all the earth. I mean, hallelujah, we've got opportunity. God gives us to be able to tell others. Because it is no secret what God, and it should not be a secret what God has done for me. It should be, hallelujah. I didn't tell you everybody's not the same. I understand that. We don't all... Some people are a little more outspoken than other folks are, if you hadn't noticed. Sometimes there's some that are a little louder, some a little quieter. But the key, what I'm trying to tell you is that your salvation is not a secret you have to keep. Your salvation, hallelujah, is to be something that you tell others about. What God's done for me. What he's done for me, hallelujah. I know everybody won't agree with you. Some people might say sometimes, well, I don't really think you are. Well, that's all right. But what matters is, glory to God, that you know Jesus. Praise God, hallelujah, that you give your life to him. And so we need to realize, just like when we sing the song, it's no secret what God can do, what he's done for others, he'll do for you. With arms wide open, he'll pardon you. It's no secret what God can do. That's what the writer, I believe it was the Gaithers or somebody that did that song. You know, Sister Amy, that wrote that song. I've seen something about them, but I wasn't sure who did. You know? Yeah, I'm sure. But it's just something to me. It's not a secret. Hallelujah, what God can do. Now, I know we'll be thinking about, well, he does great miracles. Yes, hallelujah, apart from salvation, which is the greatest miracle of all. Because, hallelujah, he brings us from death unto life. Gives us an eternity with him. But he does. He does great, mighty things. And it's so it's no secret. I mean, it's the truth of the matter is when we see the sun rise and we see the sun set, well, that's the glories of God. So it's no secret what God can do. He can do great and mighty things. But I want you to know, hallelujah, he does, praise God, save sinners. He says this in Colossians chapter 1, verses 3 through 6, and then verse 23. We give thanks to God and the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, praying always for you, Paul, writing to the Colossians. Since we heard of your faith in Christ Jesus, of the love which you have to all the saints, for the hope which is laid up for you in heaven, whereof you heard before in the word of the truth of the gospel, which has come unto you, he said, to the Colossian people, as it is in all the world. In other words, the gospel was never made to be a secret. You see, I know there's some books that's been road in the world that says it holds the secrets to life, and it's got all these different formulas that you do. But the Bible holds the secret to life, and it's open to the world. It's glory to God, no secrets. Hallelujah, has been given. Praise God, and the fallen man that he might know the God who created you. And so, we have, hallelujah, such precious promises, you see. And so he tells us there, he says this then in verse 23 of this, he tells us, you continue the faith ground and settle, be not moved away from the gospel which you have heard, which was preached to every creature which is under heaven. And Paul said, I've been made a servant or a minister to the gospel. He tells us, it's no secret what God can do. You know, I thought about the last few weeks, we've been looking into the Word of God some, and Jesus told those disciples there when he was at the woman at the well, and they had come worried about him because he hadn't had something to eat. He told them, he said, listen, I have meat that you know not of. He said, in other words, that word basically means my portion. And what it is, he said, is to do the will of the Father. He said, that's what sustains me. That's what animates me, gives, puts life into me. Hallelujah, to believe, because what am I going to do? He said, well, look out and see, hallelujah, the fields of white, the harvest. Go in glory to God, sow the seed of the Word of God. Water the seed that has been sown. You'll see an increase. God will give it. He tells us to not keep this secret. Take this. And that's what would animate us as believers. It's what stirs us, glory to God. I want you to know, if the angels in heaven rejoice over one sinner that's been saved, how much more so for believers to know that God is saving sinners just like me. Glory to God, he saved a sinner like me. I thought about how that we, you know, I told you, I believe maybe last Sunday that heaven is, you know, that joy that is set before us that Jesus spoke about, that they spoke about when Jesus was looking for there on the cross. That heaven is that joy. Well, you see, for us, hallelujah, as it was for Jesus, he didn't hide, glory to God, what he did. Praise God, he came into the world. Though the world received him not, he came, hallelujah, and he made himself known. It's no secret what God can do. He saves sinners. Romans 8:31 tells us this, as believers. What shall we then say to these things? Boy, if you read this passage, it'll be good to you. If God's for us, who can be against us? So if we have, as I said, I thought about all the testimonies. If you go over in Hebrews 11:32 and Hebrews 12:1, you find they were those that, glory to God, that testify of what God has done, praise God, of his salvation. In fact, he went so far to say in Hebrews 11, he said, if I really tried to continue to tell you, he had done told a list of the ones that, of different ones in history that had known God, and he said, but if I continue to try to tell you this, he said, there'd not be enough time for the sinners that God has saved. Those that he has brought into himself, it's not going to be a secret, hallelujah. We want it to be that the world know God saved me, a sinner. That, hallelujah, he's still saving sinners. But praise God, we got something to tell, hallelujah. And I'll tell you what, if we want to really be stirred and encouraged in the Lord, then what we have, we don't keep secret. I really believe that, that it's part of what, as Jesus said, it's what stirred him. It's what will stir our soul. Anytime we get an opportunity, just tell somebody what Jesus did for me. I didn't say you go around and got to poke your thumb in everybody's face, but God will open a door and give you an opportunity to see it. If you take those possibilities, the opportunities are coming. But you can tell somebody, I want to tell you what Jesus did. It's not a secret. No. Let's pray again. Father, we thank you and praise you for giving us this time together here this morning. And I do pray that you'll make it real in each of our hearts. It would not be a secret, hallelujah, if we know Jesus, that others would know. I pray that you'll touch every heart. Stir us, hallelujah. And help us to remember these, and we could have had so many that we thought about and wrote down that we have seen, hallelujah, the salvation of God. We have seen what you've done. There's no secret what you can do, what you've done for others. I pray, Father, that if there's one here today that doesn't know you as their Savior, I ask you, God, please save them. And as children of God, those of us that are here that know you as our Savior, let's not keep it secret. Help us to tell others what God can do. In Jesus' name.